Here we're going to discuss what are called logarithmic functions. So to motivate what we're talking about, first consider exponential functions. So in particular, I would like to consider with you the exponential function f of x is equal to 2 to the x. Now, this we know is an increasing exponential function, right? So that looks something like this. Okay, now, this function I can see, or this graph, I can see rather that this function from this graph, it's 1 to 1. And how do I know that? Because this function passes the horizontal line test. No horizontal line crosses more than once. And so let me write that down. The function is 1 to 1. And that implies that this function has an inverse. Okay? So let's go ahead and find the inverse of this exponential function. Recall, the way we do that is we first write y is equal to 2 to the x, and then we switch the x and the y. So we get x is equal to 2 to the y. Now, the next step, we're using the switch and solve technique. The next step would be to solve for y. The only problem is that we don't have any algebraic methods in place for solving for this y. So what we're going to do is we're going to invent a notation that gets the y by itself. And here's the invention. It's y equals, okay, here we go, log, L-O-G, base 2 of x. You see how that 2 is a little lower? This is called the base of that logarithm. Now, you should know that this equation and this equation are logically equivalent. In other words, consider the first equation. The ordered pair, when x is 3, what would y be? Well, 2 to the third is 8. Now, the inverse has the ordered pair with the coordinate switched, satisfying it, right? So this equation is satisfied by 8, 3. And I can check that, right? Because when y is 3, x is 8. I can see that works. Now, I said that this is logically equivalent to that. That means that the ordered pair 8, 3 satisfies this equation as well, okay? So these two equations are logically equivalent, and you can always use one or the other. In fact, we're going to go back and forth between these forms very often. And the way we do that is if you have a logarithmic form, you simply take the base, 2, and you raise it to the y, and you set it equal to the x. So let me explore that with you for a minute. So let's see, this equation is true when y is 3, right? So the y is 3, and that's equal to log base 2 of 8. So what I basically did is I took the 8 for the x and the 3 for the y, and that gave me this equation. Now, the way you can always verify that a logarithmic equation is true is you take the base, you raise it to the whatever number's on the other side of the equation, so in this case, 2 to the third, and that's equal to 8. So this is true, okay? And we're gonna be doing that, doing more of that in a minute. But that's how it always is. Base raised to the other side of the equation, this is an exponent, that should be equal to the argument here of the logarithmic function. Okay, back to this example. Now, when y is isolated, remember what we're doing here is we're finding an inverse. So we replace y with this notation. F at negative 1, or f of negative 1 rather, of x is equal to log base 2 of x. So we read this as f inverse is equal to log base 2 of x. And what that's telling you is something very important, that the exponential function and the logarithmic function with the same base, right? The base here is 2, the base here is 2. Those two functions are inverses. This is a very important idea, that the log function is the inverse of the exponential function. So of the exponential function. Okay, so now you should know, let me write this down, with the same base. This is a very important idea. So if your original exponential function has a base of 2, so does your inverse logarithmic function. And it goes the other way. If your logarithmic function has a base of like 1/3, the inverse of that is the exponential function with a base of 1/3. Okay, one more point about the inverse. Remember, do you remember how the graph of an inverse is related to the graph of the function? Well, if you the way they're connected is if you draw the line, let's draw the dotted line y equals x. Okay, that's not the straightest line I've ever drawn, but this acts like a mirror. Okay, so this was the function, if you recall, 2 to the x, and the inverse of the that function, the graph of it is the mirror reflection across y equals x. So let me draw that mirror reflection now. That's going to look like this. And that's the domain, that is the logarithmic function, log base 2 of x. Now, I can see that the domain of the exponential function, right? I can see that it's negative infinity to infinity. And the range I can see is from 0 to infinity. I can tell that by looking at this graph. So likewise, whenever you have the inverse, the domain and the range are switched. So for the logarithmic function, the domain is 0 to infinity, right? Because it's the range of the exponential function. And the range, well, what's that going to be? The range of the logarithmic function is going to be the domain of the exponential function, so from negative infinity to infinity. Okay, so this graphical relationship here is based upon the fact that a function and its inverse are always mere reflections across the line y equals x. Let's get a little more practice working on this, working on evaluating logarithmic expressions. And then we'll come back to graphing in a moment. Okay, let's evaluate log base 3 of 9. Now remember, you want to, whatever this is equal to, it's some number here, and what's got to be true is that number raised to this as an exponent has to be 9. So let me say I'm not sure right now. What you can always do is say, logarithmic equation can always be written as an exponential equation. All you do is you take 3, you take the base, raise it to the other side of the equation, so 3 to the x, and you set it equal to whatever you're taking log of. So 3 to the x is equal to 9. And then you say to yourself, what number should go here? 3 to the what gives 9? And you can see that x would be equal to 2. And that means this is a 2. In other words, log base 3 of 9 equals 2. And when you write that, always look at it and make sure it makes sense, right? It does. 3 to the second is equal to 9. So I put a little check mark. Let's take another one like that. Let's go with log, how about base 5 of 1 over 25? Well, I'm not sure, but I know whatever this is equal to, right? This number is an exponent. So that's what logs basically do. They give you exponents. Exponents for what? Well, you take the base of the log, in this case 5, raise it to not sure yet, and I get 1 over 25. So can you think of a number such that 5 to that number is 1 over 25? Well, it's not going to be positive 2 because that's 5, 5 squared would be 25, but negative 2 will do the trick. So x will be negative 2, and that's why log base 5 of 1 over 25 is equal to negative 2. And check it, make sure. 5 to the negative second is 1 over 25. Let me write that down, see if that makes sense. 5 to the negative second is 1 over 25. Yeah, that's right, because 5 to the negative second, it's 1 over 5 squared, which is 1 over 25. That looks good. Okay, so now that we understand how to evaluate logs and what they are, let's go ahead and graph a logarithmic function. Okay, let's graph f of x equals log base 1/2 of x. Now, you have two options for graphing this, and I want to talk with you about both of them. So option one is this. You simply take your logarithmic equation and you convert it to exponential form. So here's how you do it. You take f at x and you write it as y equals log base 1 half of x, right? All I did is I replaced f of x with y. And then you write this in exponential form. So you take the base, the 1 half, and you raise it to the y. That's how it goes, right? 1 half to the y equals, and we're going to set it equal to x. Now we can use this equation to create a table of values. Let's do that. Okay, so now usually when we create a table of values, usually it's easiest to pick x's and figure out what the y's are. Not the case here. Why? Because you're taking 1 half and raising it to the y, and that's equal to x. So it's much easier in this case to pick y's. So for example, I'm going to pick y is equal to, how about 0, then 1, 2, 3, and negative 1, negative 2, and negative 3. So what is x equal to when y takes on these values? Well, 1 half to the 0, right, that's equal to 1. And then 1 half to the first is 1 half. 1 half to the second, right, I'm plugging 2 in for y. 1 half squared is a fourth. 1 half to the third is an eighth. 1 half to the negative first, that's equal to 2. 1 half to the negative second, that's equal to 4. And let me show you how to find the next one. 1 half to the negative third. So 1 half to the raised to the negative third. That's equal to, remember, when you have a negative exponent, you can make it positive by taking the reciprocal of the base. So it's 2 over 1 to the third, which is equal to 8. Okay, so I get 8 there. And now I'm going to plot these values, right? So 1, 0. X is 1 half, y is 1, so 1 half 1, maybe in there. X is 1 fourth, y is 2, so 1 fourth 2, maybe right here. X is 1 eighth, y is 3, so way up here. And then, let's see, what else do we have? X is 2, y is negative 1. X is 2, y is negative 1, like so. Okay, X is 4, y is negative 2, maybe right there. X is 8, y is negative 3, all the way down here. Okay, now you can see what the curve is going to look like. It's going to look like this. Okay, before I graph it, I want to show you another way of getting this table of values. So this is going to be OR. And you can use whatever way is easiest for you. Now, the OR method is based upon the fact that I know what the inverse of this function is. F inverse, I know. Right, I know that logs are always inverses. This little notation, remember, means inverse. So the inverse of f is, well, it's the exponential function with the same base. So the inverse is 1 half to the x. Now, that means I can take this, you know, if I write this as y equals 1 half to the x, I can quite easily create a table of values for this function. So x, right, and then I say, okay, you know, I'm going to pick x's and figure out what the y's are. And now I can go through my x's and say 0, 1, 2, 3. Let's go negative 1, negative 2, and negative 3. Now, when you plug in the x's, 1 half to the 0 is 1. 1 half to the first is 1 half. 1 half to the second is 1 fourth, right? Because you're squaring 1 half. So this is a fourth. 1 half to the third is going to be 1 eighth. 1 half to the negative first, again, it's going to be 2, this is going to be 4, and this is going to be 8. Now, these ordered pairs are not the ordered pairs you want to graph. But remember, these are ordered pairs for the inverse. And you can always get the ordered pairs for the function you want by simply switching the ordered pairs for the inverse, or the coordinates of the ordered pair for the inverse. For example, do you see how this ordered pair, for example, is 2, 1 fourth? That's for the inverse. But that means the function, the original function, must have the ordered pair 1 fourth for x and 2 for y. And it does. Look, over here, x is 1 fourth, y is 2. All I did is I simply took this ordered pair and I switched it to get that. How about this? 3, 1 eighth. 1 eighth, 3. Oh. Negative 1, 2. 2, negative 1. So you can create this table because it's quite easy, And then you can simply take all those ordered pairs and switch the coordinates to get the graph of the inverse of the exponential function, which is the logarithmic function. You follow me? Okay, so let's go ahead and plot the graph, the function through these points. Okay, so this is our graph of log base 1/2 of x. Now, of course, this is the graph we're after, and it's a good idea if you want to, just to double check, make sure you understand where the inverse would be graphed. The inverse is the exponential function with a base of 1/2. This is a decreasing exponential function. And what you could do is you could draw in the dotted line, y equals x, like so. And remember that the graph of the inverse is always the mirror reflection of the function you're talking about. So 1/2 x, or 1/2 rather raised to the x, looks like this. So if I'm drawing this graph in, this dotted graph right here is the graph of 1/2 to the x. And I can see that that graph of 1/2 to the x looks like a mirror reflection of log base 1/2 of x across the line y equals x. And that's because 1/2 raised to the x is the inverse of log base 1/2 of x. Okay, so that's how we evaluate and graph deal with logarithmic functions. I should just point out right away, or one last thing, that the domain, remember, for this function, I can see it's from 0 to infinity, right? X has got to be positive, and the range is from negative infinity to infinity. Okay, so that takes care of logarithmic functions for us. Until next time.